Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic, that is a continuation of the classifications of routing protocols in ad hoc networks. So far you have seen the hybrid routing protocols, proactive routing protocols, reactive routing protocols. Now let's see the hierarchical routing protocols. So these protocols are introduced to hierarchy in the network to achieve the following benefits. So the name itself is saying it is following the hierarchical structure and the network will be arranged in the hierarchical form. So let's see, this protocol introduces a hierarchy in network to achieve the following benefits. So what are the benefits? Reduction in the size of routing tables, and for better scalability we are using the hierarchy in network. So the hierarchy routing protocols are used to reduce the size of the routing tables and for better scalability. So now let's see how it is going to reduce the size of routing tables and for better scalability. Hierarchical state routing protocols, that is you call it as HSR, which is an example for this routing protocol. This hierarchical state routing protocol is characterized by the following. HSR uses multi-clustering to enhance the resources allocation and management. The first step, it is using the multi-clustering. So why it is using the multi-clustering? To enhance the resource allocation and management. The hierarchical state routing defines the different levels of clusters. So it is going to define the different levels of the clusters. What are the different levels of the clusters? So at every level, leader is elected. So here you can see the topology, the hierarchical state routing protocol topology written here. So here the levels are there. This is level 0, level 1 and the level 2. So at each and every level, a leader will be elected. So did you observe here? In this level, the green round circle, that node is the leader. And here a leader will be there. And here the leaders are there. So at every level, leader is elected. The first level is made of single hop clusters. So it is made of, this is one cluster and this is another cluster. So for each cluster, one leader will be there. So in the second level, you are having only one cluster, so one leader. And in the level 1, you are having the two clusters and two leaders are there. For each cluster, one leader. The next level is comprised of leaders of clusters. So here you can see different levels are there. Total 4 clusters are there. The flow for 4 clusters, here it is present. So this is a topology of the HSR, hierarchical state routing protocol. So it's just maintaining the hierarchical structure. Suppose at physical layer nodes, so at the physical layer, nodes are classified into cluster heads, gateway nodes, normal nodes. So what is cluster heads? The cluster heads belongs to a single cluster and erected as a cluster head. So the cluster head is having only the single cluster. So whenever the single cluster is there and only the node that is present can be elected as a cluster head. Gateway nodes, it belongs to two or more clusters. Normal nodes belong to a single cluster. Let's see the cluster heads. The cluster heads at level 0, the physical level could be responsible for, means this is a level 0. So which is a cluster. Cluster head. Okay. So the cluster head at level 0. So this is a level 0, which is a physical level, could be responsible for slots or frequency or code allocation to utilize the spectrum more efficiently and call admission control from normal member nodes and scheduling of packets for transmission. So these are all the responsibilities for this cluster heads at level 0. So whatever the cluster heads here, the 3, 9, 12, 6, 17, these are the cluster heads. These cluster heads' role is to call admission control from normal member nodes and scheduling of packets for transmissions. And it also doing the exchange of routing information and handling the route break. So those here, the main difference here in this hierarchical is for each circuit there is one clusters will be there. So those are maintaining the neighboring nodes information. So whenever there is a route handling road break or exchange, if you want to exchange the routing information, scheduling of the packets, every work can be done by the cluster heads. And the gateway nodes are responsible for forwarding of packets between different clusters. That is a cluster heads. So the gateway nodes are two or more clusters. So here this is a gateway. This is the level. It's a passing. The gateway clusters, forwarding of packet between different clusters, the cluster heads. Next, the routing responsibilities are assigned to nodes in HSR. How the routing responsibilities will be assigned to the nodes? Every node maintains information about the status of the link with its neighbors. Like, this information is broadcast within the cluster at regular intervals. And the cluster head, whatever the cluster head that is present in the network, those head exchange the topology and link state information at any level. So this is done via multiple hops using the gateway nodes. And it also do the path between two clusters head involves multiple links is called virtual link. So this is a head gateway like that. It continuing. Every node knows the exact hierarchical topology information. So whatever the node that is involved in the network, that node knows the exact hierarchical topology information. Like after obtaining the information, the cluster head floods it into a lower level. Okay, and to route packets, hierarchical addressing is used consisting of, so to route the hierarchical packets, how the addressing will be done? By using the hierarchical ID, that is HID, which consisting of the sequence of cluster headers IDs from higher levels. And it holds that route packets holds the information of node ID also. Hierarchical ID as well as the node ID. The node ID is similar to the unique MAC address. Suppose if you take the address of node 12. So how you are going to find the address of node 12? So this is a node 12. Okay, so this address will be 9 12 12, so which having the hierarchical ID and the node ID and the node itself, node ID, hierarchical ID. So from 12 to 9 to 3, there over multiple links will be present. So here I just given the basic introduction of the HSR, that is hierarchical state routing protocol, which is an example for the hierarchical routing protocols. So here this HSR, this routing protocols, hierarchical routing protocols are used to reduce the size of the routing tables and for better scalability. Thank you.